Because he was the one who changed me. He was the one who molded me. He is the one who shaped me. He is the one who revealed all to me. He loved me. He carried me. He took the nails for me. He died for me. And he still is doing it for me this day. Can I get someone to say, in Christ I am.
In Christ I am.
In Christ I am.
In Christ I am free.
In Christ I am redeemed. In Christ I am made whole. In Christ there is peace. In Christ I am loved. In Christ I am called, chosen, and set apart. In Christ I am forgiven. In Christ I live and have everlasting life. You see, before the devil took my pain and used it to hinder my purpose. But God, someone say, but God. He took my pain and he propelled me into purpose. Don't let your life just end in pain. Yet let your life be driven to a place of purpose. My story is not the most unique. Some of you may have had similar stories. But that's perfect. Because let us all understand that one thing we all have in common right now is that all of us have experienced pain in some shape, form, or fashion. Some of us right now are experiencing brokenness to some extent. I'm wondering, how can I leave this situation? How can I see my way? Can I leave this relationship? This life seems too much. This is too much pain and suffering. Why is this happening to me? Why did my husband leave? Why did this happen to my child? Why did I have to be abused? Why am I always feeling alone? Why can't I ever be chosen? Some of you are saying to yourself, I don't feel that God wants to speak to me because he's mad at me right now because I'm doing something not aligned to his will. Respectfully, sisters, I don't know exactly what problem that you're facing right now. I don't know if you're having a drinking problem. I don't know if you're having a smoking problem. I don't know if you have a lust problem. I don't know if you have an attitude problem. I don't know if you have a relationship problem. I don't know if you have a health problem. But what I do know is that he is able to fix it, and he is able. Amen. So come as you are, but do not stay as you are. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all else shall be added unto you. You don't need to be doing the cleanup. All you need to do is surrender and submit to him. And the Holy Spirit will use his power to take you from glory to glory. Will the process be painful? Yes, it will. It will be painful. But at the same time, as he is purging you out of yourself, he will fill you back up with his peace, he will fill you back up with his power, and he will fill you back up with his presence. Anyone who knows Jesus knows that Jesus is a sweet, sweet, sweet God. His presence cannot be matched. He is truly the comfort of this world. I just have a couple practical ways in which you can go closer to him. You may want to take some notes, may not want to just adjust it to your spirit. But first thing you need to do, as you wake up, acknowledge him. Firstly, yes. Acknowledge who he is. Acknowledge him for the life that he has given to you. So there's time that you can spend with him. If it's 20 minutes a day, spend that time with him. And as you spend that time with him, your desire for him will grow. To be with him, to commune with him will grow. Worship and praise him. Read the word daily. Fellowship in a church. Be a part of a church. Do not forsake the assembly of the church of your brethren. Seek deliverance. If you know there's something going on, seek deliverance. Become mentored as that person will keep you accountable. They will keep you in check. They will keep you aligned to the will of the Lord. Journal your thoughts to him. I'm not cruel to my products, I'm just saying. Journal to him. Declare His goodness over your life. So what is her sister's kickball ministry all about? In closing, if you really want to know what we are all about, we are all about bringing healing to women through the transformative power of Christ and pointing women to building a deeper relationship with the Almighty Father, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, from a life of sin to a life of freedom. Because in the beginning, He will build a foundation. He will take His time to mold you. He will take His time to prune you, to build your character, to correct you, to shape you into looking more like Him. So now you can go reconcile yourself unto others. I'm just going to close right now. And one of the things that I typically do as part of my devotional kits is something called a love letter from God. A love letter from God. So He gives me inspiration. The Holy Spirit gives me inspiration to what message He has for His daughters. And He gave me something here for you guys. So I hope that you can get into a space of intimacy with Him so you can receive it. So I just allow you to take a couple of seconds just to get in that place. Dear daughter of mine, I am happy that you are here, not only in this event, but that you are taking a step towards knowing me even deeper. I see you, I see your tears, I see what excites you, I see what drives you, I see what frustrates you, I see it all. You cannot be hidden from me. Indeed, I am the one who created you. And by no mistake, you are unique and a masterpiece. One of a kind, precious. The world may have certain expectations of you, and that is a worldly expectation and judgment, and that is understandable. But do you know what I see when I look at you? I see my child. My precious daughter, my sweet little girl. Oh, how I look forward to spending time with you. My heart becomes filled with joy and love only to spend a few minutes with you. I cherish these moments forever. To be able to hear your stories, your concerns, your daily issues and occurrences, your little stories, your little laughs, your little cries. I am here for you anytime you need me. Please know that nothing can compare to the love I have for you. My arms are always open, whenever you need me, for comfort and support. You can rest, pause, take a deep breath, breathe. You can rest your burdens on me. I can handle it. Oh, how much I love you. I am counting on the time till we speak again, till we spend time again. How I wish you knew how precious you are, how much you are worth to me. Please never settle for anything that is not my best for you. I only have the best in store for you, now and in the future. I see your efforts. Don't lose hope, my child. Keep pressing forward. I see your heart. I see you. I am and will always be here waiting for you. I love you. I love Jesus. Before I end, I just want to say thank you to Ms. Carly for having me give me this opportunity. And I just want to close off in a quick prayer for you, ladies. Heavenly Father, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, I pray for my sisters, Lord. Father, I pray that you touch their hearts, O Lord. I pray, O Lord, that right now, Lord, even as you move in this place, let your presence